Two years he's going to, so I'm not fully calm, just going to check it all time for each and every one of them. And I'll take you then, be checking the video it, or you want, to do it. And then we'll come back, and we'll run through certain places finding in with to show you how to walk correctly, see if we're actually using that. Show you how to do it, run through that a few minutes. And then we'll show you how the U-key would have to rise after being thrown. A certain way that you have to get up. And it's quite easy really. Provided you do everything you try to do. Now, I'm not going to say that you're going to get put through to complete power this day. And that's why we're naming two weekends. Or you can complete it. What I try and get you to do the techniques near enough, right, you're not in the correct first time anyway. So I've really gone through that. In the second session, we might only make halfway before we get there. Right? So there's no point in rushing it. So by the time you get halfway through the end, you've forgotten what you've done. So it's much better to do and we'll do half day and half next month. Alright? Anybody got any questions on that before you? Alright, so what we're doing now then is if you want to go back to where you were sitting, you sit there. How do you want them to
anyway?
Do you want to do it? Would it not be better if then look at you and see the way that he gets up after he's 10 feet and what he does? Okay? No questions on that? Alright then. If you go back over that side, let's keep it out the way it can, right? Oh, sorry, go sorry to the wrong right.
Thank you.
something to be expected anyway. But so what we're doing now, I pictured all from where you are, if you stand up, now you two, if you're not to come down this way, and walk across the map that way, in Sugiyashi, right? Yeah. Forward and backwards. No, Sugiyashi. No, that's you now. Left-handed techniques, obviously you use the right leg to go under the left leg. distance if you walk down to about 12 inches, so that both feet are always in contact with mat. That's how you should use a tatami, is that your feet, never lift your feet up, because that could be fatal for a counter throw or something like that, so you don't want that. Always keep the feet in contact with the mat all time. Now, immediately Tori arrives at Yuki, you go straight into the technique. So you go back with your left foot. If you're doing a right-handed technique, always the left foot moves first. The left-hand technique, the opposite. Your right foot always moves back first. Okay? So we're doing Uki Otoshi is the first technique. Okay. Nice and fast, so he generated the speed to be able to get the movement to execute the technique. Spins on his left knee, and then with your right hand, the right hand, because you're throwing with the left hand, the right hand, just gently with the back of your own hand, pushes your partner's arm forward. Now that's his signal to begin to rise. Alright? So you don't rush it. In other words, you're waiting for each other. Alright? So you're working together, and that's what they call working in harmony. So you've got to try and get the time together to be able to do it. Alright, you won't do it straight away. Nobody's worried about that. But the more you practice it, the more experience you gain. Okay? We'll see that technique again, just right-handed this time, please. Alright, you see the speed that you do it? The only reason you can get that speed is cutting the distance of your step down. Lovely. Right, are you... You're in the right view, keep them tall, is it?
No.
Alright, place your partner that you're going to practice. It's speed that's going to get you in trouble or out of trouble. By doing the short steps, you should be able to go up to your partner, immediately take a hold, and you take the first step back with your left foot. Alright, that is Tori. So, the only way you can successfully do these techniques without losing your balance, if you lose your balance, you've done something wrong. You should always maintain balance. So the only way you can maintain that is by movement. The movement has got to be quick movement, like these two layers have shown you. It's got to be done. If you do it slow, you're wasting your time. It's got to be done at a speed, so you've got to work yourself into a routine, a proper routine of how to do it. It's only fast movement that will allow you to do the technique properly. Alright? So we'll show you once again, stay where you are, just show how you approach, hopefully you stay there when you've done your technique. Don't swing your left leg round, sideways, because by you doing that, you've put yourself off balance immediately, so that your left foot should be round, move your left foot, round. That's right. So in other words, if I'm coming down that seam there, or that seam, whatever, you should work in line with that seam, so that both Tori and Yuki finish in a straight line. So that left leg is straight on the line, because you're moving on a straight line, you should finish on a straight line. If you move that left leg round, you're doing exactly what you're doing in Sugiash, you put yourself off balance. Alright? So move in a straight line and make Yuki move offline. That's the object. You move offline, and that's why you stretch back that little bit further to give your partner room to get by. If you're too close, you'll knock you in the shoulder, knock your technique spoiled. Alright? So you must move in a straight line, and then when he spins, he's still running parallel with the seam. Move the left leg round, that's it. So now he's getting on with the seam, and that's how it should be. Alright, you got any questions on that? Don't be afraid to ask. And I don't want to give anybody a rocket and you start crying and telling them I can't stand that. You know, I can't stand the skippers. You're not going to cry, are you? Right, Cianardi, eh? Right, with this one, it's if on Cianardi that you're after. Now, when Yuki has got to attack, now he attacks by stepping back strongly with his right foot, and there's got to be full commitment with this blow. He's aiming the blow to the head, for the top of the head, and it's got to be done with full commitment, otherwise the technique is not, you have difficulty with it. Okay, show them out. Right, now the thing is, he's aiming the blow for the head. You don't, like in some Carter books that you pick up, it shows you to block first. Now if somebody aims a blow with full commitment, it'll break your arm, like that. So you don't do that. What you do Tai-Sabaki, which is the way that you move your foot, you swing your left foot behind the right, and you swivel and face the opposite direction. See, like that, in turn, your Tai-Sabaki. Do the Tai-Sabaki then. He turns, swivels, and looks at the wall, and the blow misses the head and comes off onto the shoulder. And without any hesitation, he turns and takes him over on the full technique. Right, once more, please. That's Tai-Sabaki immediately catches the arm. Shoulder, his arm doesn't come, but it comes in the crook of his arm. So he puts the arm up and then Yuki's arm lands inside the elbow joint and it continues into the technique. Now you all happy with that? You got any questions? You sure? It's a lot to remember in that. Don't forget you've got to step back with a blow and aim the blow with 100% commitment. If you don't, it's no good of aiming the blow and stopping and wait for your partner to take the arm. The technique don't work like that. It's only worked on your movements. Your movement. As soon as you see the arm draw back and start to come forward, that's when Tori begins his turn. He begins his turn. It means to say, once he's started, he's committed himself to that blow, then there's no pulling back. He's got to continue into that blow. By the time Yuki realised it, it's too late. His arm's been captured and he's going through the air. Okay, right. It's an art. If you study the art, then you've got to study it properly in an art. So sport has got no part in classical art. If you want to do contest, that's up to you entirely. But I won't teach you contest, although I used to do a hell of a lot of contest when I was coming through the ranks. But now I saw the light. And if you want to be use judo as an art, then you've got to do classical. And classical means that you've got to do pure form. Pure form is the way that we do it here. Alright? Okay. Let's do it now. So category is the shoulder wheel. Same again, so that when you aim a blow to the left, once the arm begins to straighten, that's when you should make your turn to avoid the blow from the arm. Can you do that? Very slowly. Start to turn. Good, that's it. So the blow's missed the target now, it's gone round the back of the neck, and he's now pushing his hip through to pick him up. By aiming the blow, he's opened his hips, so his arm, his left arm, goes around the hip, and then if he keeps turning his head to the right, he just drops. Slowly once more. Don't get tight back in. Very small base again. All hip technique. Very small base. Don't open your knee because it makes your hips weak. Any questions on that? Sure, don't be frightened to
show you again. As you go in. Start from the home run on the second stage. Just pan that and then you turn from the third. Slowly.
Watch it one step. The third step.
Second step, your hand just goes behind.
Yeah, so the third step you do toss it back in. Yeah. All right. More than that. How about you, Deirdre? You can do it?
Yeah.
How about you, Sid? You happy about that?
Yeah.
Sure?
Sure, I'm
okay. Sure. How about you?
Yeah.
You do it all right. Just keep smiling. You know, you have to be second group, that's all. You might manage to get to four or even five, but you might be able to manage a lot.
The big brackets always have these.
Yeah. Watch it carefully as you slow down. What's happening is that Tori is going in to do the technique, which is resisting hip thrust. Now Yuki, when he turns in to try and throw him, Yuki resists. So in other words, you're pushing his tummy out to try and push him away. You see that? So the tummy. So what Tori has got to do, he's got to adjust now, so he opens his knees or lowers his knees to get below his hip to overcome that resistance. Otherwise, if he don't bend his knees to get lower, he won't be able to throw it. And then simply pull him over into hip throw. Right? Yeah, and again, please. There you go. Any questions on that? It looks quite simple, you know, when you do.
had a lot of practice at it.
Do you actually do this with your hand or...?
No, it's just some striking in the body.
Yeah. You can use it for the hand.
But that makes it extremely awkward for the other way.
So it just looks to me straight up.
Yeah.
It's
just okay. Slight bend in the knees.
Alright. Anything else? How about you, Priscilla? No? Because as he moves, takes all steps, he puts himself on path. step, the third step, is what I'm getting confused with. Third step, I take the shorter, not longer, I take the shorter step, so that when he takes his third step, I would be like that, so my step is a bit shorter. So as he starts to move his foot to regain his balance again with that one, then that's where I sweep it. So when he both feet is together, he wants to make another step. His balance is broken because he moved away from me. That's what he should look like when you sweep. Alright? If you try and sweep, in actual fact, in that position, his legs should come up that high. If you've got him right in the right position. But his balance must be broken like that. That's how you break it, otherwise you can't break the balance. Alright, so that's your third step. So if we show it just once more, please. Keep the third step short. Just like that. Alright? Now he makes a second. shut the same place. Now, on the third pull, Tory don't move, he stays there. The third pull, he pulls UK right onto his hip. Now, the reason that you do that is so that there is no there's no chance of an accident happening to UK, because if there's a gap between UK and Tory, then UK is open to an injury if Tory leg goes wrong. So to avoid that, you make contact with your back. So then, even if you miss with the leg for some unknown reason, UK won't. There's no chance of him being injured. All right, you all know what I mean by that, don't you? There's no chance of you hurting your opponent. So, but this is the confusing part, is how far does Tory adjust himself? If he turns too far, he can't get the technique, he takes the wrong leg. But Uchimata used to take the leg nearest to you, which is Yuki's right leg. That's the thigh that you attack inside the right leg. If you attack the wrong leg, it's not Uchimata in the pure sense, it's a variation. Alright? Because there's a possibility you can leave your right leg still in contact with the mat. And then the contest conditions, it wouldn't value 10 points. Okay? So your first pull, you pull him round and there's a gap between the two of you. So Tory adjusts himself by turning it one foot like that and the other foot like that. So he's only adjusted slightly. On the second pull, the same thing happens. His left foot goes there and it there. And you don't move anymore. But Tory will pull Yuki right round and pull him onto his back. Onto his back. And then he can lift his right leg and take Yuki's right leg. Alright, is that all clear? Okay, demonstrate that nice and slow for him so they can follow. Please. With that Tory comes to Yuki, and then when he arrives, he immediately pushes him back to break his balance. That whole idea, he breaks his balance. So you come up to him, and you're going to push him back. Take the grip, but he keeps pushing. Stop, that's it, down you go. And as he goes down, he steps forward with his right foot, Yuki, and goes into falling off his right foot. Alright, let's do that again. And take note that Tory will sit down and begin his attack when Yuki's right foot is backward. Now, during the time that Tory is sinking down to place his foot, he pulls his weight, pulls Yuki forward, so he has to step with a big step forward with his right foot, and that puts him in the right position for rolling back forward. And then he comes up on his knee in the old form of kata. It used to be that Yuki came up on both feet, but I couldn't find any logical reason why he should be asked to do that. But all the others with Temawada finish on one knee, so I place this technique in the same category as that. So that all the Temawada and all the Temawada finish on one knee. Okay?
Questions on that one?
what's the next one? Or is that the last one?
That's the last one.
That's the last one. Right, run quickly once through each one. And keep your eyes open, anything particularly you want to see. Keep it there. If you move it away, You lost the principle. As I was saying to you earlier, technique is a series of principles, and you miss out one principle, the technique's what? It's not been nominated. All you're doing is a variation. So keep that tight into the side. And with this technique, Yoko Gaki, is that you've got to pull strong. You pull strong. And the way you do that is that you move the left shoulder. You pull with the shoulder. So you turn, the whole object is for you to turn, you're turning your partner all the time because you've got to attack his leg from the rear. Not from the side. You're attacking him from the rear. But you can't do that. And if this arm's floating free, you can either pull him too strong where the elbow's gone back there, or you don't pull him strong enough. But with that, it's no mistake. You move the shoulder sideways, so you've got to move the feet as well. So you pull him again, sits with the shoulder. I'm not pulling him with the arm, I'm moving him with the shoulder. And that's all Yoko Gaki is. It's two strong pulls, and then both of you collapsed in the mat. Is that clear? Sure? Mm. All right, let me give it a try then. We show it again here. Pull strong each time. There you are, down. You both fall down. Tory turns in the opposite direction, and then you're facing each other. Right, once more, please. Same turn, Matthew.